I can't believe it's over.
I felt so good!
That was the best climbing I've done in my entire life.
God damn.
Nice. Good job, man.
Thanks for the blade, dude. That was perfect.
Thanks, dude. Awesome. Dalton, one of the best.
In the middle of nowhere.
The diamond in the rough.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah, it's a little bit touching. Yeah, because and see the process of like, oh, this can never be done, you know. Being abandoned for many years, and then you know, that's seeing the final send of it. It's a little cool to watch, you know, the last old route that the dry had just being sent. You know, being finished. That's pretty cool.
It's pretty wild. The route came together a lot faster than I was expecting. Especially from last year, I was expecting it to just be full battle mode the entire time. I didn't even know what sport climbing at your maximum level felt like. It's such a different challenge than I would have ever imagined. When you wire a route in, the way it feels to climb it, like perfectly, the way it feels to like be breathing through these moves that once felt hard. It's crazy. The mental battle, the mental endurance through the whole like process of working the route and through the whole process of red pointing the route is something that you can't get through bouldering and that you can't get through competition.
Yeah, this one was, it was the hardest thing I've ever tried, and I think it was kind of perfectly within my wheelhouse.
I haven't really done anything of this caliber, so the best that I can give it is a reference point.
I'm just mostly curious. I have so many questions about how my strength translates to climbing grades. As more people grade it, it'll just answer those questions.
Aside from the difficulty, this route has everything that I look for. It's got sick grips that leads to unique and complicated movement, and it's a standalone line.
The developer's original vision was to go to the top of the headwall, and he put in anchors where he thought that the route would end. He called it the $6 million man project. I think that is what this route was meant for, that is the route's potential.
Taking Lee Majors to the top through the headwall? That would be insane. You know, yes, I know a lot of climbers, I looked at it, a lot of climbers have thought about it, but we were like, yeah, you know, it's too hard. And now that we know it's possible, seeing it done, another classic, you know, another amazing classic to be able to watch, to be able to see.
Growing up, I would see all these like 515As and 515Bs going up, just assume that they were the same as the 512s that I was climbing. You know, they just happen to be there. Mother Nature left them for us, and it's our privilege to climb them as they are. And then as I've gotten older and learned more about the history of climbing and hard route development, I've learned that Mother Nature doesn't leave us very many 515As and 515Bs. And I think that just makes this route all the more special.
This route does have one chipped hold from when it was originally developed that connects two natural sections of climbing, but It's the 60-foot head wall of all-natural hard climbing that gets me psyched.
Bolting the head wall was my first experience bolting, and just as difficult as I imagined it would be.
Yeah.
Equally psyched and equally intimidating.
Oh, man.
Look at that. You see, like, the black and brown streak that kind of goes all the way down? It kind of goes from white to gray rock. I think I'll put the anchors on the gray rock, just so you go to the very top. Little 3/8 inch.
Got my hammer.
Straight from the Revolutionary War. Step one is to scope the lie that you think is possible. And then you bolt it. You try to see if the actual sections that you saw from the ground are the most naturally climbed sections.
So there is a line now that goes from the anchors of Lee Majors to the top of the cliff, and it adds about 60 feet of featured limestone, kind of gently overhanging climbing.
The head wall we thought was going to be pretty much vertical, especially compared to the steepness of the cave we just climbed out. But then when you're rappelling from the top, you end up getting down to the level of the anchors and you're like 20 feet away from the cliff. So I was looking at this thing and I was like, oh man, it's gonna be like 13B, C, going from the anchors to the top of the route.
Take.
And then I got on the climb and it's like V10 for the next 15 feet.
I mean, I think people committed to developing roots at the hardest level.
That's sick. God, so savage.
They search for this kind of root and they're lucky to find one.
And for me to find it kind of on my first outing, I mean, it just like doesn't seem fair. But I'll just take it for what it is.
That's sick.
I think that'll be usable once you're above it. Sick grip, holy shit.
The holds always feel better in your imagination than they do when you're on the route.
Oh, take.
I was like, oh, I'll just like crank on this, come into this, just pop to that one.
This is the physical crux of the entire route.
Shit.
I can't say for 100% certain.
Why did I think that was possible for me?
But I will say that I wasn't able to figure it out in the 2 days of trying it. So from the jug, you're on this weird right hand. Your fingers are all isolated. You have like a two finger crimp with your middle two and then one perfect little divot for your index. I think you have to go big left hand.
Dude, that thing is like this angle and I'm trying to grab it like that.
It all comes down to that move. If that move goes, the route goes. It's the last link. Once you clip the anchors of Lee Majors, you might get a couple shakes on each hand, and then you're into this 15-foot V10 section.
Tic-tacky, slow climbing on not in-cut holds. Get a high foot and do this big lock-off to a wide pitch. That move's one of the sickest, I think. And you end up 5 feet away from the jug with one little arrowhead looking triangle crimp you can grab with one hand, stepping feet up real high and kind of pouncing over my body to this jug. My second session on the upper boulder, Ben suggested trying a knee bar because there's like a little mini roof.
Slotting the knee bar makes the boulder feel possible, because without it, there's no real way to use these bad holds.
And started feeling really good. As soon as my right hand left the alien pocket, the left pinch.
Oh! No!
No!
The mini pinch!
Fuck, dude.
15 off, look at that.
Based on how good the holds are, the distance between them, kind of an intuition for how weird the move is gonna be, I'm thinking V13. I think the route's possible. And I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna finish what I started.
Man, how lucky are we to have this natural test piece in the US? There's not a lot of these around. And this route represents a level of difficulty that I've never attempted and that already means a lot to me. And it's already motivating me to train harder and level up my climbing so that I can possibly do the route. And I'm excited to see what it ends up meaning to a lot of these other climbers that I look up to.